Yeah, hello everyone. In the previous video, I explained the socket application interface and also we explained the socket creation, bind function, listen function and accept, and after that how the connection is established, and also we seen there. And here that is the diagram representation you are seeing here. See here, there is a client and server which are in the different hosts, two different hosts. At the server side, the socket creation will be done, and after that bind function which is in the TCP closed state will be there, and after that listen function, the TCP will be in the listen state. And here the for the acceptance function at the server side, it is in the passive open, means the server won't initiate any connection, rather than it will wait for the connection. And coming to the client side, it is in the active open. Here at the client side, the socket creation will be done, and after that by using the connect connection, by using the three-way handshake, the connection will be successfully established. See here, the client will send some synchronization with a sequence number J, and that is received by the server from the network, and the server will sends an acknowledgement with the client's sequence number by adding 1, and also it sends the synchronization of K. At the client side, the connection is completed, and it sends an acknowledgement with server's synchronization member by adding 1. In that way the connection is successfully established. This is the TCP connection setup. Now we will see in this program representation. So these are the header files we have: hash include stdio.h, standard input output header file, standard library error number .h, string .h, sys slash types .h, net internet slash in .h, sys slash socket .h, system slash wait .h, and here the here we are defining the port number as 3490, and the backlog is 10, means how many pending connection queues will be hold. So I told that in the previous video that the server side different connections, new connections will be available, and the connection setup is successfully done. All those connections will be stored in the form of a queue, and the kernel will take care about that. Here generally the server can interact with multiple clients at a time. So here when interacting with the multiple clients, but here the communication will be done from point to point, from one server to only one client the communication will be done, but the server can interact with multiple clients at a time. So whatever the new connections are available, those connections will be stored in the form of a queue. Okay, so here hash defined port, here I am taking the port number as 3490 by the for my program, and the backlog is up to 10. Up to 10 new connections I can store in the form of a queue. Okay, here at the server side, the main function here int socket fd, socket file descriptor and the new file descriptor. Here I am taking the listen on socket file descriptor, and for the new connection I am taking the new file descriptor. Okay, here I am taking the two variables like this, and here sock struct sock addr underscore in my addr, this is the my address, it is a server address, and here sock addr underscore in their address, it is a connector address, there it is a connector address which is connected. Generally I am talking about the client and server, so it is the client address. and here int SA underscore size. Here it represents the size. Coming to here, for the socket creation, if socfd, socket file descriptor is equal to soc underscore with within the bracket pf underscore inet soc underscore stream comma 0. Here it is nothing but an pf underscore inet is nothing but a protocol family. Either we can take the version protocol, internet protocol version 4, or we can take the internet protocol version 6. So in that way, which type of protocol family we are choosing. And soc underscore stream is nothing but, and we can choose the style of communication. Here we are taking the TCP or UDP we can take, but in the program representation I took the protocol family like TCP. And here the protocol, initial I am taking the protocol as 0, is equal to minus 1, then the socket is an error, exit 1, come out from that particular thing. So if it is successful, it is okay. If it is minus 1 means the error is occurred and come out from that. Here the socket is not created. And after that, here we have to my address dot sin underscore family af underscore inet. See here, while the socket creation is done, there we have to byte ordering. For the byte manipulations also, we have to do the protocol family host byte order. For the host byte order, we have to take like this. And after that, myaddr.sin underscore port, host to network, my port. There we have to take the short network byte order. This is the socket address structure. For the representation of the socket address structure, we have to take the host byte order and host to network. And after that, my underscore addr dot san underscore addr dot s underscore addr host network in addr any. So in that way, the socket, see here, in addr any allows client to connect to any one of the host IP address. To connect to any one of the host IP address, there we have to choose sin underscore family, sin underscore port, sin underscore addr. And after the B0, by using the Brickley software distribution, we are taking the Brickley software distribution. Here we are choosing the, within that we are my address dot sin underscore 0 comma 8. In that we are taking. So this is the representation of the socket address structure. These are all. And after that, socket creation, the socket address structure we are choosing. And after that, bind function. If bind of socket file descriptor struct soc addr star my addr. So here the my addr is nothing but an server address, and the size of struct soc addr. Here the size means address length. It has to show the address length is equal to minus 1. Then the error, p error within the bracket bind. So whenever the bind connection is done, the error will be there and will come from exit 1. If the is equal to minus 1, if not, then the bind connection is successfully done. So in that way, here the socket file descriptor and server address, which it contains the local IP address and the local port number and the address length. And after that, listen. In the listen function, we have the two arguments like socket file descriptor and the backlog. Is equal to minus 1 means the error is occurred, exit of 1. And coming to this here, while of 1, for the acceptance function, sin underscore size is equal to size of struct soc addr underscore in. So here, for the acceptance of the connection from the client, here it has to mention the how much of size the client is sending the data. For that, if new underscore file descript is equal to, okay, new file descriptor means new connection is arrived to the server side. So for that, the acceptance has to be done. So for that, new underscore FD is equal to accept of socket file descriptor comma socket struct socket addr there addr comma ampersand sin underscore size. Here the sin underscore size is nothing but an address length. It shows the size of the address, and the their address is nothing but an who is interacting or a new connection is came. Their address in that their addr, which it contains the IP address and the port number. If it is successful, it's okay. Is equal to minus 1 means there is an error, and continue. Here the continue is nothing but an for a new connection, it will check. If any connection has error, it will continue. Means it will skip that and will continue the another new connection. Printf server got connection from. Okay. Inet underscore network 2 N2A their addr dot sin underscore addr. In that way, the result function and accept function will be done. So here the server side, socket creation, bind function, listen and accept will be done. And after that, from the client side, the connection will be established. For this establishment of a connection, we have the header file like sys slash socket.h, and for the int connect, within the bracket int socket file descriptor, struct soc addr, serve addr, comma int address length for the establishment of a connection. So here, connect to another socket. To connect to the another socket, for establishing a connection, we have to connect to another socket. If it is successful, it will return 0. Minus 1 if any failure is occurred. Socket FT is nothing but socket file descriptor. Serve addr is nothing but its IP address and the port number. Address length is nothing but the length of the address structure, which it contains the size of struct socket addr underscore in. For the connect, before connecting the socket, generally it contains the socket dot socket underscore state is equal to ss underscore unconnected. Here the socket is unconnected. It is in the unconnected state, and after that the connection will be established. Add the sock to TCP listen underscore hash waiting for the server response. So before it is unconnected, while the server side is in the listening mode and the connection will be established, then it will come TCP underscore listening underscore hash waiting for the server response. Come into the client side program. For the socket creation, if socket FD is equal to socket protocol inet socket underscore stream comma 0 is equal to minus 1, the connection socket creation is failure and exit of 1. So here pf underscore inet is nothing but a protocol family, which we can choose the IPv4 version or IPv6 version, internet protocol v4 or v6, or socket stream is nothing but an, here we are taking the style of communication. I choose the TCP protocol for the communication, and the 0 is nothing but initially I am taking the protocol as the 0, and after that there underscore addr dot sin underscore family. Here socket address structure for both the server and the client side, here the socket address structure must be mandatory. So here sin underscore family, here I am taking the af underscore inet, and the sin underscore port number, here I am taking the h host network, and sin underscore addr I am taking like a struct in underscore addr star he underscore h underscore addr, and the b0 Brickley software distribution b0 their addr dot sin underscore 0 comma 8. In this way I am taking the socket address structure, and after that socket creation connection will be done. If connect off socket file descriptor comma struct sock addr their addr comma size of struct addr is equal to minus 1, then there is an error while socket creation connecting, for the connection establishment there is an error and exit of 1. here the there ADDR is nothing but an who want to initiate the connection or who want to get the connection. That connection we are calling as an their ADDR. In generally, we can call as an client address and the client port number, and the size of is nothing but an address length. Here it is nothing but an, here up to now we discussed about the creation and setup, establishing a connection for both at the client side and the server side. Now how to send and receiving the data, sending and receiving the data, now we will discuss here. Write or read data to or from a stream, connected datagram, connected datagram. Here it is a UDP socket. See here, write or read data to or from a stream is nothing but an TCP protocol. Connected datagram is an UDP socket. We will discuss about the TCP and the UDP. Here in write function, here we have the int socket file descriptor, char star buf size underscore t n bytes. Okay. Int for the read function, int socket file descriptor, char star buffer and size underscore t n bytes. And for the UDP socket, we have the read or write a datagram to or from a UDP socket. Int send to and receive from, these are the two functions which are involved in the UDP socket. In the send to function, we have the socket file descriptor and char buffer and size underscore t n bytes, and also we have the flag and socket address, destination address and the address length. In the receive from also, we have the socket file descriptor, char star buf, size underscore t n bytes, int flag, struct socket address, source address and address length. And here in the receiving and sending the data, for the TCP protocol, we are using the write and read functions, and the UDP socket, we are using the functions like send to and receive from. In the next video, we will see the continuation. Thank you.